You never ever
look as good as me. Then turn to the other side and slap me in every high five and say, I know that's right. You don't know, I think, I just was looking at my notes, and we started talking about coming before you and giving you great content, falling within the theme of leadership and communication at the beginning of February, all right? So she had you on her mind at the beginning of February to make this a unique program, to make this a great program, and to help you grow as an individual. And look, she always, I don't know if you know, I hope she don't mind it, tell you this, you know, she kind of sleeps during the daytime because she works at night, and I call her sometimes, she's like, hello, who is it? What? I'm like, okay, all right, it's just me. But she answered the phone during the daytime, and she's been great, and she wanted to make sure everything's awesome for you. I just want to give her a round of applause. And thinking about you and caring about you, also. Also want to thank Tishon and the young lady, what's your name? Patrice, they kind of been talking back and forth on working on some things for the introduction. And I'm a member of West End Toastmasters. I guess I can't say I'm a member, but I'm not an active member of West End Toastmasters. And one of the things Tishon brought back to my memory of how do you introduce people? How do you bring them on stage? How do you make sure that they are uplifted? And I think I want to thank Tishon for doing a great job with that tonight. And I really appreciate you. So she did an awesome job. And the reason I mentioned that I was a member of Toastmasters because I'm a living example of all the things that Toastmasters stand for and it can help you with. It can help you with your leadership, it can help you with your communication, and it can help you with your personal development. And it was wonderful that our Toastmaster of the evening asked the question, are leaders born? And see, if you get too deep with it, you probably say, no, leaders are not born. But guess what? Boy, say what?
What?
We're all born, right? So leaders are born. So one answer to the question is, yes, leaders are born, right? So that's one of the answers to it. But I think what happens with that question is a lot of times what people are asking is, are there natural born leaders? Yeah. Are there some things that are inherent to you that will cause you to be a leader, will cause you to walk your way through society? And I just want to have been told, I'm not cinched, but I have been told I'm a natural born leader. And I'm going to tell you some things about myself as we look back over my life, and that's probably going to bring out some of those things. But the other thing is this, no matter what your talent is, no matter where you are in life, you still can get better. That's one of the reasons I joined Toastmasters, because I wanted to get better with my leadership skills, with my communication, and my ability, here we go, my ability to take a concept and articulate it in a meaningful manner. We're in the information age. And one of the most important things, if you want to get to the next level, if you want to elevate, you're going to have to be able to communicate in writing or verbally. All right? So if you see someone passing you at your job, you see someone, you sometimes like, why am I getting passed over for promotion? Think about this. Are you communicating in writing? Are you communicating verbally in a manner that people can receive your message and they can articulate it within the mission of the company to elevate you to the next level? Okay? So that's one of the things that Toastmasters does for you. I know we have some guests. So if you want to elevate your leadership skills, you want to elevate your communication, and if you want to be in a great club, because when we have great people, then this is a club that you should consider joining. All right? Now, I want to start off, I think I already started. Did I already start? I think I already started, right? I want to talk about what is a leader. Okay? What is a leader? And this definition, it's a simple definition, but sometimes the application is challenging. It's a simple definition, but sometimes the application is challenging. Listen to me. A leader is someone who knows the way, shows the way, and goes the way. A leader is someone who knows the way, shows the way, and goes the way. What are we talking about? Let's break down each part of it. The first part is a leader is someone who knows the way. The leader is the person that has the vision
for the company or for your life. So if you're leading yourself, you have a vision for your life, where you want to get, what you want to be, how you want to grow. Okay, so you know the way for your life. And then if you're a leader at your company, if you're a leader at your church, if you're a leader at an organization, then you have the vision for that, so you know the way. Okay, our Toastmaster, our president, they know the vision in Toastmaster, but also they know the vision for this particular club. When we talk about shows the way, what are we talking about? We're talking about demonstrating how do you get from where you are to that goal you have for yourself or for that club or for that organization. All right, how do you get there? What's the plan? The leader knows that, and the leader's going to do what? He's going to articulate that to you in what? In writing. Or perhaps in words, verbally. So leaders are the one that what knows the way. Now they're showing you way. But this is the key. The leader's not just going to say, hey, our goal is over there. Where we're trying to go, our vision is over there. You just go, right? What the leader's going to do is going to take you by the hand, going to walk with you along the way, along the path, along the journey to get to your goal. All right, that's what a leader does. A leader is what? Someone who what knows the way, shows the way, and goes the way. Who's with me? Okay, one person is with me. That's all right. Here we go. Now, just by show of hands, how many leaders do we have in the room? How many leaders do we have in the room? Okay, all right. We got most of us with our hands lifted. And that's 100% awesome, because this is the key. As a leader, there's three groups we always lead. Three groups. We're leading ourselves, we're leading others, and we're leading leaders. That's the highest level of significance, leading other leaders. We're leading ourselves, we're leading others, and then we're leading other leaders. What are we talking about? When we're talking about leading ourselves is, it took some effort to get here this evening, right? Okay, so you remember my definition, you had a goal, you know the way, and then go to it. So you had to figure out the way to get here because it was something here that you needed. And one thing I know about everyone in this room, because we're here, because we want to get better, we want to be, we want to know, we want to have more. We want to be, we want to know, we want to have more. That's why you're here. Okay, you want to take your leadership, you want to take your communication to the next level. And leadership is a way that we can do what? It's a pathway. It's an opportunity. It's a bridgeway to what? Be, have, and do more. And if you start to look at your life through the lens of leadership, then we have a common vernacular. We have a common way of seeing things with other people and developing our relationships. And then we have a measure to start from where we are to where we want to be. So leadership is a measure of success, is a measure of taking us from here to there, is a measure of taking us from where? From potential to success. And it also covers the widest gap in the world. The widest gap in the world is this. The space between knowing and doing. It's the widest gap in the world between knowing and doing. Because I can ask, I won't ask you a question, because I can ask everyone in this room, where are you trying to go? And you'll say, I'm trying to get to this place. It could be a goal, it could be an aspiration. And I can ask you, how are you going to get there? And you say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that. Then when I ask you, have you done it? That's when people get silent. All right? Because we have that gap from what? From knowing to doing. And leadership is a way to see the world, to view the world, and help make that gap smaller by moving from where we are to where we need to be. And I want to talk to you about a couple of concepts in leadership. Our topic tonight is called Transforming Your Life and Business with the 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership. And I pull some of my content from this book. It's called the 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership by John Maxwell. Okay? Who knows who John Maxwell is? Okay, a few people. Just to refresh your memories, John Maxwell is the number one leadership expert in the world, hands down. He's wrote 60 books, I think it's 72 now, 72 books, and they all center around the themes of communication, leadership, and personal development. So I'm a certified speaker, trainer, and coach with the John Maxwell Company, but I also have my own individual company. So what I'm going to do is pull some thoughts from the 21 irrefutable laws, and we all know based on time, we can't get to all 21. But if you want to go further in your personal development, in your leadership, then I provide an opportunity at the end. If you want to study with me further, you want to get some additional information, I'll provide an opportunity for you to do that. I won't leave anyone out, and then we can continue this journey together. But tonight I want to hit at least two laws, and the first law I want to talk about is the law of process. The law of process. And with the law of process, this is good news. This is good news for you. The law of process says what? Leadership develops daily, not in a day. Leadership develops daily, not in a day. Why is that good news for you? It's good news because tonight is just either one, a continuation of your journey to from where you are to where you want to be, looking through the lens of leadership, and or it's the beginning of seeing myself, okay, I'm a leader at this particular level. Now, how do I get to the next level? And the good news is, it's a process. It develops daily and not in a day. And when I told you I was going to tell you some more things about me as we go along, I want to illustrate through some things in my life how leadership it develops daily and not in a day. And this is the key. It took me 40 years to get here. And the reason I can say that is because I wasn't qualified or developed 40 years ago. So I started my process, my journey in leadership is when my high school principal called me into the principal office one day, my freshman year. I'm scared to death, and I'm shaking, I'm sweating. Because I was like, they didn't really catch me this time, did they? So he called me in, and it was Mr. Williams, and he said, I'm Dwayne, your principal from middle school, he called over here. He says he wants you to come back and speak to the middle schoolers on how to do good in middle school and how to get prepared for high school. And I was like, yes, yes, right? Because I was just going to get out of his office. So I said, yes. And I left the office and fell against the wall. And I got to sweat. Like, all right, I made it through this time, right? So I had jumped into this area of leadership, not really knowing what I was doing. But I pulled together my people in my family. I talked to some teachers. And I talked to the principal. And I put together a great speech that helped what? Our middle schoolers to move from where? From where they were, right? Middle school to high school to where they needed to be. They wanted to what? They wanted to be, they wanted to have, they wanted to do more. So at that time, I was able to do that and I started my journey. Leadership develops daily, not in a day, 40 years ago. And then as I got through high school, senior year, I was voted most likely to succeed. I was voted the homecoming king and the history award in high school and some other things. And I went to college and I became the president of my fraternity. I was a member of the Black Student Alliance, the member of the marketing club. I did some things there. Then I left, then I went to law school, North Carolina Central University School of Law. I went there, I graduated at the top of the class. I was a member of the Moot Court Board. We traveled around the country in competitions. I took the bar and I passed it the first time. And the reason I tell you all these things, not to impress you, but to impress upon you, if I did it, you can do it. Because leadership develops daily and not in a day. And it took some time for me to do some things. I had to learn some things before I came here to be able to tell you this. I had to do some things before I came here to tell you this. I had to go some places. I had to go halfway around the world. I had to go to India and talk to them about leadership and come back and share those experiences. I had to go across the California, Wisconsin, all around the world to become what? The leader that I am today. But what? Leadership develops daily, not in a day, but I'm still going. So this is good news for you. All right? It develops daily, not in a day. And this is just a catapult. This is just a boost, if you will. This is just some inspiration to take you where you want to go. So leadership is a process. It develops daily and not in a day. And this is key. You're probably thinking, okay, if it's developed daily and not in a day, how do I determine where I'm at? How do I determine where I'm at so I can have a measure of moving from where? From potential to success, from where I am to where I need to be. Here we are, four stages. The first phase is this. I don't know what I don't know. What you're probably hearing tonight or going to hear is some concepts or some things said in a way that we never heard them before. Some things you want to be exposed to that you didn't know was a part of being a leader. Now, you're on phase one. I don't know what I don't know. Now that you know that, here we go. How do we get to level two? I know what I don't know. What is my plan for growth? Okay, you're hearing some things, some concepts coming into your mind, and some things coming. Your spirit is jumping, and some things coming. These are the things I want you to pay attention to. Everything's not for you. It's certain things tonight that's for you, and when you hear those things, lean into them, grasp them, write those things down, then you'll know, hey, what do I need to put in my plan for growth? All right, that's step two. Then we do what? I know and grow. It starts to show. Okay, you're starting to grow. Your life is changing. The things around you are starting to change. And this is the thing. Don't get scared. All right? Don't get scared. Because what's going to happen is this. You're going to start to grow. The things around you are going to start to change. You're going to leave some people. You're going to leave some places. And you got to continue to grow. That's the sign of your growth. But don't get nervous. Hopefully, those people will go with you. Hopefully, they are trying to grow. Hopefully, they are trying to get to the next level. If they don't, you're going to have to continue to progress. Because I had a coaching client, and she called me on the phone, and she was in tears. And she said, Mr. Bennett, she said, now that I've been listening to tapes, I've been reading books, and we've been working through some issues, I'm starting to grow, and I don't have anything in common with the people around me anymore. She said, I don't have anybody to talk to. And she said, it's lonely. What should I do? I said, continue your path of growth. Get into a Toastmasters. Get into, we have a certification plan. Maybe you want to get into a certification plan. Join me in one of my groups. That way you'll be among people like ourselves, like-minded people that want to grow. There's nothing wrong with the people that we'll surpass and we're moving, but we got to go somewhere. We got to go somewhere. We just got to be honest. We've wasted too much time. So we hope that they go with us. We hope that they are grasping. We hope that they are finding out where they are in one of those phases, and then they'll start to grow. And then once you do this, once leadership becomes a part of your life, once personal development becomes a part of your life, once great communication becomes a part of your life, you'll do it naturally. You'll do it naturally. As our Toastmaster said, you'll be developed. Then you'll be ready to go to the next level. And then that may be one area of your life. So once you get there, then what you do? You start over with another area. Then again, you find out things I don't know, what I don't know, then I know what I don't know, what I don't know, then I grow, right? Then I grow and start the show, right? Then I simply go because of what I know. And then you move from where you are to where you need to be. You're closing that gap, right? Between what? Knowing and doing. Okay, then you're getting closer to your goals. Now, let me give you a couple of ways, very, very concrete ways that you can specifically move your progress in leadership. Very, very specific. One, what are you doing right now to build yourself as a great leader? Now, if you're a member of Toastmasters, that's a path. That's a way to go. If you're not, become a member of Toastmasters. Become a member of this club. That's a path. What are you doing right now to build yourself into a great leader? That's what we do. We build and develop leaders. So this is a great place to be. And remember I told you about the great relationships here. That's a great, this is a great club to join. Number two, here we go. And I'm going to ask you this question. But what book or books are you reading right now? What books or books are you reading right now? And this is the wonderful thing about books. You can get the wisdom of an individual that took him 50 years to learn, you can get it in a week. You can get it in a day if you read that book a day. Sometimes we forget the fact that people write books. Yeah, we have fiction, but the non-fiction is, this is my life's journey. This is where I started off. These are some of my struggles. These are some of my adversities. These are some of the things that came against me, but I was able to move along this path. I was able to move along this pendulum of life, and now I'm here. But within that story, just like when you hear my story, that may be something that you grasp onto. And if you grasp onto those issues, if you grasp onto that adversity, if you grasp onto that struggle, now the gentleman or the young lady in the book have told you a way to do what? To close the gap between knowing and doing. Third, what seminars are you enrolling in? A lot of times, and this is just life, you're going to have to spend some money in order to get better in personal development. You're going to have to spend some money to get that promotion on your job. You're going to have to spend some money to grow a business. So when we talk about what seminars are you enrolling in, enrolling should be investing in. Because when you pay this money, you're investing in yourself. So the reason I want to break that, because I'm just keeping it real. A lot of people think, hey, we can get from here, from there, we can do this and that, and we can do it for free. I'm just letting you know, life is nothing free. And what I heard one time, if you pull out a person's checkbook and look at their checkbook and you see where the check's right, that's the type of person you're going to be. So if I ask somebody, let me look at your checkbook tonight, what is it going to show me? What is it going to tell me about? All right? So when you hear seminars, when you hear people say, hey, you know, we want you to pay some money to join this and join that, if your spirit feels it, if you lean into it, if it's something that you felt that you're supposed to do, then go ahead and do it, because it's not paying money for something. It's invested in your own personal development. That's what we're talking about. And then, what sacrifices are you making to reach your goal? What sacrifices are you making to reach your goal? And when people hear the term sacrifice, a lot of times we think that's a negative term. Who's with me? People think, I got to sacrifice. Oh, man, I can't. If I got to sacrifice, I can't do it. But let me kind of give you a mind shift when you talk about sacrifice. My definition of sacrifice is this: giving up something on a lower level to achieve something on a higher level. Giving up something on a lower level to achieve something on a higher level. What am I talking about? The easiest one, don't raise your hand, is TV.
I'm saying that
too much TV. All right.
TV.
Yeah. And I'm saying everyone is guilty of that, because I had to do this. I had to stop. I knew too much about what was going on in the election. Now people want to say, you need to know what's going on, you know what's happening. Well, somebody's going to tell me whether I look at it or not. Right? But I knew too much about Donald Trump. I knew too much about Ted Cruz. I knew too much about Hillenburg. I knew too much about that, because I got somewhere I got to go. I got to get ready to come and talk to some people for personal development in SBC Toastmaster. So I can't be sitting there looking at TV all day long. I got to read this book. I got to put my notes together. I got to get my mind and my spirit together, because I got some people I got to help. So I'm giving up this political election for what? For you. I'm giving up something on a lower level because I'm going to be here for you. I'm going to give the best to you to take you all to a higher level. And it's taking me to a higher level. So when we talk about sacrifice, you've got to give up something on a lower level to get to a higher level. And you should be identifying that now, because once you hear a speaker, once you start to get motivated, once you start to get inspired, then the thoughts come into your mind. And see, that's what I believe as a coach. As a coach, I believe that the answers are always inside of me. When I'm coaching people, they get mad at me. Why do you keep asking me questions? Why do you keep asking me questions? I ask you a question and you don't answer. Because I don't want to give you my answer. Because my answer may not work for you. But your answer is within inside of you. And one of the things my company does, it helps pull those answers out. So when we talk about a law or process, here we go. Here are some concrete things we can do to do what? Develop our leadership, because we said what? Leadership develops daily and not in a day. How we doing?
Man,
all right. Now, question. How we doing?
Good.
Doing good. All right. Make sure you're good. Now, let's make a transition and move to the law of the lead. It's another leadership law. Now, the reason we name those name them laws is because this: a law, the same thing happened to everyone if they applied a law. The same thing happens to everything in life. Doesn't matter the color, doesn't matter the time, doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter what you're doing. Now, I'll give you an example. The law of gravity. The law of gravity says this: this beautiful 9-month-old baby is laying on the bed. They roll over and fall off the bed. And the law of gravity will be like, bam, they hit the floor, right? Yeah. The law of gravity is not going to say, oh, they don't know any better. Yeah. Or they're too cute. Or they're just a baby. Anyone that rolls off the bed is going to hit the floor. That's how a law works. So if you apply these laws to your life, you're going to get the same results of others that apply those laws. I've applied these laws. Mr. Maxwell applied these laws. Other member of Toastmasters applied those laws. Your leaders have applied these laws. They may not have articulated in a way I'm articulating them tonight, but they've applied these laws, and now they're being developed. All right? So when we talk about a law, if you follow these laws, you get the same results in your life. So we got the law process, and now we have what? The law of the lead. Leadership ability determines a person's level of success. All right. Now, this one is so important. I usually don't do this, but I wrote out the entire definition and the entire thought so that you can get it. So I won't leave anything out. All right. So I'm going to read it to you and read along with me. Leadership ability is the lid that determines a person's level of success. The lower an individual's ability to lead, the lower the lid on his potential for success. The higher the individual's ability to lead, the higher the lid on his potential for success. All right? Now, let's do an illustration. Usually when we're talking about a scale on anything, we're talking about from 1 to 10. Usually 1 being the lowest and 10 being the highest. Okay. As we go through our stages of leadership, if you identify yourself as being a number 3 lead, so you're on the number 3 level of leadership. What that means is those 3 groups of people we talked about at the beginning, yourself, others, and other leaders, they'll never get higher than a 3 because this lead is going to keep them from getting higher than a 3. Now, we said that if we engage the principles of personal development, we can go higher, right? So if we raise, here we go, raise our lid on our leadership to a number of what? 5, then all the people, all of the services, all of our promotions, all of the jobs, all the things we want are going on a higher level. So as we raise our leadership ability, right, our level of success raises. Now, this is not a trick question. All right, it's not a true question. How many people in this room want to be successful? Okay, 2. That's good. All right. We had 1 at the beginning, and we had 2 now. Oh, we got 2 more on this side. All right, everyone wants to be successful. So again, remember I told you at the beginning, if you see your life, if you see your position at work, if you see yourself through the lens of leadership, now you have a way to measure where you are. You have what? A plan for growth. And now you have a way to take your leadership to another level, which will what? Take you, take your organizations, take your family, take your company, take the corporations to a higher level. Because now you're going to be greater and successful. Okay? Now, I'm never going to leave you with the concept without giving you some concrete ways of doing it. Now, here we are. This is the thing that I'm doing a lot more of this year. Value your experience with reflection. Value your experience with reflection. What are we talking about? When you leave here tonight, you wrote some things down. You took some notes. There's some things on your mind. Sit down for 10 to 15 minutes. Organize your notes. Write down the things that came out of your spirit, that came out of your mind that's applicable to you. Take this experience, reflect on it, and then take the steps you need to move. All right? A lot of times we're busy. Everyone's busy. And we're going through life so fast, we're missing some things. We're missing opportunities for growth. We're missing opportunities to get better because we're not reflecting on what was good, what was not good. Every day, or at least once a week, or at least once a month, just take a look back and see what was the great things that happened to me. How was I successful in these particular areas? Then you take those things that you're successful in and apply those to other areas of your life. And then the things that you didn't do so well, the things that you perhaps need a little more work on, if they're necessary for your journey, continue to use those things, but they're not, let them go. How do I get to that? I value my experience with reflection. All right. Number 2, we already talked about investing in training. We talked about that, and you know who you know what specific training you may need. You know what may be necessary for you. You know what is going to help you in a particular area. And each one of us has some different areas that we can do some things in. 3, mentorship or coaching. Now, I mentioned earlier that my coaching philosophy is that the answers that you seek when you become under the tutelage of a coach are within you, and the good coach helps to bring those answers, help you figure out the path on your own, okay? That's a stark a difference between that and what? Mentorship. And what mentorship is, I think we need...